Hello, we're going to continue with orders of operation, and we're going to look specifically at parentheses and how when we evaluate expressions with or without parentheses, how that affects our outcome. Okay, so let's look at this right here. 5 times 6 plus 3. Okay, we know that we use PEMDAS parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division, addition, subtraction. Okay, so, let's look at these three expressions which have the identical numbers and operations, but the parentheses are different. So, in this first example, we would use, there's no parentheses, there's no exponents, but there is multiplication, so we'd multiply first, we'd get 5 times 6 is 30, we'd have plus 3, and we'd get 33. Okay. In the second example, we have parentheses around the multiplication, so there wouldn't be any change. We would still get 30 plus 3 is 33. The third example, however, the parentheses is now around the addition, which forces us to do the addition first. So we do 6 plus 3 is 9, and we have 5 times 9, which is 45. So here's three examples of how parentheses can change our outcome when we evaluate this expression. Okay, let's look at this example. In this example, we have division and we have subtraction. So no parentheses, no exponents. So multiplication, division, left to right. We have division, so we have to do division before we do subtraction. So 9 divided by 3 is 3. Then 3 minus 2 is 1, okay? Okay, in this example, we have parentheses, so we're forced to do what's inside the parentheses first, okay? So 3 minus 2 is 1, and then we still have 9 divided by 1, which is 9. So again, you can see how the location of the parentheses and just having parentheses completely changes our answer. Let's look at another one. Okay, so in this one we again have no parentheses, no exponents. We do have multiplication, so we'll do that first. 4 times 2 is 8. We'll bring everything else down. Okay, so now we have subtraction and addition. And it's addition or subtraction, whichever comes first, left to right. So we're going to subtract first. So we have 24 plus 8, and that's 32. All right. Now, this one, we do have parentheses. So we're forced to do that first. So 12 plus 4 is 16. We'll bring everything else down. Now, we have subtraction and we have multiplication. Multiplication comes first, so we'll do that. So 16 times 2 is 32. And we have 36 and we subtract. So 36 minus 32 is 4. So again, you can see the location of the parentheses completely changes our answers. So without parentheses, when we evaluated the expression, we got 32. With parentheses, when we evaluated the expression, we got 4. Okay, let's look at this problem. All right, orders of operations, no parentheses, no exponents, but we do have multiplication, so we'll do that first. Bring everything else down. Now, we have subtraction, we'll subtract from left to right, so 17 minus 12 is 5, and 5 minus 4 is 1, okay? All right, this one, again, we're evaluating now with the parentheses and see how it changes our evaluation of the expression. Okay, so we're forced to do parentheses first. 17 minus 4 is 3, and then we still have times 3 minus 4. So now, We've done parentheses, no exponents. Multiplication comes before subtraction. So 3 times 3 is 9, and minus 4 is 5. So again, without parentheses, we came up with 1, and when we added parentheses to our expression, we came up with 5. So we're asked, how can we find an evaluated answer of 14 by inserting parentheses? So where would the parentheses need to be placed in order for us to get an evaluated answer of 14? Pause the video and see if you can do it. Okay, so let's try this. If we put the parentheses around 6 minus 4, that forces us to do the parentheses first. So 6 minus 4 is 2. Bring everything else down. All right, now, order of operations. Multiplication or division, whichever comes first. So we have 5 times 2 is 10, plus 8 divided by 2. And now we are doing division next. So it's going to be 10 plus 8 divided by 2 is 4. And that does give us an answer of 14. Okay? Now, the second part of this is, where can you put the parentheses and come up with an answer of 24? Pause the video and see if you can figure this out. Okay, if we put the parentheses here, order of operations that forces us to do parentheses first. 4 plus 8 is 12. We'll bring everything else straight down. Okay, so now we have multiplication and division, so we'll work left to right. We'll do 5 times 6 first. And we'll bring our minus 12 divided by 2. Okay, now we'll do our division. So 12 divided by 2 is 6. We'll bring our 30 down. And 30 minus 6 is 24. Okay, so we've worked problems without parentheses, with parentheses, and we've also done some problems where we've had parentheses located in different locations in our expressions. And you can see by doing that, it completely changes the order of operations and it completely changes how we evaluate the expression. All right, thanks for watching. We'll see you on the next video.